We've been working on OSIRIS-REx since 2012. SDL built the focal plane arrays, the camera systems, the detectors and electronics that are on the spacecraft. There's three cameras, PolyCam, MapCam, and SamCam. PolyCam takes pictures of the asteroid when it's still far away. It helps the satellite navigate its way to finding the asteroid. And then once it's close, it has a focus mechanism, so it takes very high resolution pictures of the asteroid surface. MapCam maps the surface of the asteroid in color. And SamCam is used to take pictures of the surface of the asteroid during the sample collection. The satellite's been orbiting the asteroid Bennu for months, and it left its orbit and went right down to the asteroid's surface. It has a sample arm that's extended. That sample arm touches down on the surface of the asteroid like a pogo stick. When it touched down on the asteroid, nitrogen gas is blown through the sample arm to stir up the rocks and the gravel and put them into the sample collection. Now the spacecraft will go through a series of maneuvers to measure how much mass was collected. If sufficient mass was collected, the spacecraft will eventually back away from the asteroid slightly, linger there for about 6 months, and then begin its long journey back to planet Earth. When the spacecraft comes to the Earth, the sample capsule will be released and it will descend through the atmosphere over the West Desert in Utah, where it will be captured when it's coming down to the Earth on its parachute. This is a career-defining moment for many of us to be involved in a deep space planetary mission that will do so much to advance the scientific understanding of humankind, of our Earth, of our solar system.